गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, एज इन प्रीवियस वीडियो आई कंटिन्यू द चैप्टर पैकिंग एंड आई हैव टोल्ड यू हाउ द नरेटर जेरोम के जेरोम मीन्स द राइटर ऑफ दिस चैप्टर एज वेल एज हिज टू फ्रेंड्स जॉर्ज एंड हैरिस हाउ ऑल द थ्री वर रेडी टू गो ऑन ए बोट ट्रिप इन ए रिवर एंड फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल दे वॉन्टेड टू पैक दियर लगेज एंड यू हैव स्टडीड how the narrator had packed the bag but many mistakes he had done while packing. Then Harris and George, these two friends of narrator who started packing and they had also committed many mistakes. They had kept the light things on the bottom of the hampers and the heavy things on the surface means on the above side of those things. And it had destroyed many things. Now you have also earlier studied that Montmorency, the dog, was also sitting there all the time, and he was also disturbing them and disturbing the things that were kept there. And Montmorency was happy when somebody was teasing him and scolding him and throwing something over here. Now further see what had happened. Please open all of your book at page number 87. See there above side. Open your book all of you. To get somebody to stumble over him, him means Montmorency. Stumble means hit. To get somebody to stumble over him and curse him sternly for an hour is his highest aim and object. Montmorency liked if somebody was going to hit with his leg, and if somebody is cursing him sternly, then Montmorency liked it. When he has succeeded in accomplishing this, his conceit becomes quite unbearable. Conceit means pride. And if somebody hit him with his leg, he was cursing him, then Montmorency thought that he had a great pride. He came and sat down on things just when they were wanted to be packed, and he labored under the fixed belief that whenever Harris and George reached out their hand for anything, it was his cold, damp nose. Damp means wet. Damp nose that they wanted. Students, it was the habit of Montmorency that whatever the materials were to be packed, Montmorency was sitting into the bag or hampers, and whenever Harris and George were putting their hands into it, either in hamper or in bag, then they were feeling the wet nose of Montmorency. Yes. He put his leg into the jam, and the materials that they had packed, Montmorency went there and he put his leg into the jam, and he worried means disturbed. Montmorency disturbed the teaspoons, and he pretended that the lemons were rats. He thought that the lemons that were kept there, they were rats, and got into the hamper and killed three of them before Harris could land him. He had destroyed three lemons until Harris came and he beat him with the frying pan. Here given landline is beat, brew or beat. Harris went to the hamper and he had disturbed the materials and he had destroyed three lemons until Harris came taking a frying pan in his hand, and he beat him. Harris said, I did not encourage him. A dog like that does not want any encouragement. Harris thought that the narrator had encouraged Montmorency, but it was not right. Narrator did not agree that he had encouraged the Montmorency. It is the natural original sin that is born in him that makes him do things like that. The packing was done at 12:50, and whatever packing was there, they had stopped at 12:50. And Harris sat on the big hamper and said he hoped nothing would be found broken. And when the things were packed, the hampers were packed, at 12:30, Harris went and sat on this, and he said that nothing was broken. George said that if anything was broken, it was broken, which reflection seemed to. Reflection means your thought. Reflection means thought. Which reflection seemed to comfort him. He also said he was ready for bed. We were all ready for bed. Harris was to sleep with us that night and we went upstairs. Students, when the packing was completed, hampers were packed, bed was packed to sleep. And they had gone to sleep. But before going to sleep, they decided when they would wake up. We talked for beds and Harry said to sleep with me, he said. Do you prefer the inside or the outside? Jerome, I said I generally prefer to sleep inside a bed. Harry said it was odd. Narrator thought that he will sleep inside the bed. Harry said it was odd. Jared said, what time shall I wake you fellows? Jared was asking in the morning at which time he should wake them from the bed. Harris said 7. Then Harris replied that at 7 o'clock in the morning. I said no, 6, because I wanted to write some letters. Narrator said that he needed to write some letters, so he should wake up at 6 o'clock. Harris and I had a bit of row over it means quarrel. Harris and narrator, they discussed over this matter and there was a quarrel between them. But at last, split the difference. Split the difference meaning even your room. This means that they agreed on 6:30 because it was halfway between 6 and 7. And at last, they agreed that they would wake up from the bed at 6:30. And said 6:30. Wake us at 6:30, George, we said. At last they said that George should wake them up from their bed at 6:30. George made no answer and we found on going over that he had been asleep for some time. So we placed the bath, here bath means bathtub, where he could tumble into it on getting out in the morning and went to bed ourselves. And at last they had gone to sleep, and when George had gone to sleep, then Harris had kept a bathtub on his way so that in the morning he should stumble into it and he should feel disturbed. In this way, students, total story has not been given in this extract. As already I have told you that this extract Piking has been taken from the novel 3 Men in a Boat written by Jerome K. Jerome, and it is only some part that has been given here. And in this chapter we have studied how narrator J.M.K. Jerome and his two friends George and Harris, all three wanted to go on a boat trip into a river, and how they started piking and they committed many mistakes there, and at last the piking was over. And we have also studied how Montmorency's habit was that if somebody was disturbing, somebody cursing, scolding him, and somebody was throwing some objects over him, Montmorency was feeling pride. And if somebody was going to stumble by to hit with leg and be disturbed, then Montmorency thought that it was his pride. In this way, students, this chapter is today finished. You have to write the different word meanings that are given, that I have already also taught you, and you have to revise the lesson again. Then next day I will discuss over the questions. Thank you, students.